daughters, that we can come into your presence, oh God, that we can decree and declare, that we can boldly say, the Lord is our helper. What can man do unto us? We thank you. We love you for that. We give you all the glory. Father, we adore you. We reverence you. We appreciate you from the bottom of our heart. For all your loving kindness and all your mercies and all the awesome work you're doing and all the wonderful things you've planned way before we're formed, way before we're born, you plan to do certain great things with us. And so we are so glad that you are at work this morning. Let me share with you a memory verse this morning, Habakkuk chapter 3, verse 6. I want to share with you because I know God has always been good to us. The blessings of God is something you can't underestimate. You can't underestimate the blessings of God. You can't undermine all that God is doing in your life. You can't undermine all that God has prepared to do with you. You can't undermine all the glorious stuff he has planned to you. Habakkuk chapter 3, verse 6. When you look at the book of Habakkuk 3, 6, we will find something there that God is saying to us this morning. I want us to embrace it. His ways are everlasting. That's our testimony this morning. Our memory verse. His ways are everlasting.
Hallelujah.
Before we read the commentary this morning. The ways of the Lord are everlasting. You can't calculate for God. You can't calculate for God. Yesterday, one of the ministers at the church was sharing the word and got some insight. I love to listen when people preach. I enjoy listening to other people preach. I enjoy it. Because while I'm there, I'm focused. I want to gain something. Because I love the word of God. You see, wherever the word of God is coming, and I like that word, I'm always keen on in getting. I want to get as much as I can get from that word. I want to receive as much as I can receive from the word of God. Because the word of God has power. The word of God has authority. It can change your word. It is the word of God that gives you victory over every circumstance. It is the word of God that gives you glory over every situation. The word of God is so unique. It's so unique. It has power over your environment. Amen.
Amen.
The word of God has, how would I say it? It has life itself. It can give you life. So Habakkuk 3:6 says, his ways are everlasting. I read, what he had done at one time, listen to this commentary, he will do yet again. Man's ways are variable. I could tell you that. I have a system. If I want to do something and you cross that path, I change my mind. Okay, I'm not doing it anymore. So my kids, they know that. So when I said we're going to go out, I tell them in the morning, so they all have to behave well till we go out and come back. Because they have learned by conditioning that when they say, when they misbehave, I say, okay, the out is canceled and it's canceled. And they will not blame each other. Oh, because of you. I say, but you got to learn. And oh, because of you, you made that change. You smile. Yeah, I say, oh, it doesn't matter. That's the way of man. It's variable. It means everything can affect our mood, our event, our sequence of time can be changed. Oh, yes, next week I said I'm going to come to your place. Well, you can't guarantee that next week I'm going to come. You should be hoping that everything goes well because anything can happen to a man and a man can change his mind. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yes.
The ways of men are variable. It's a probability. But God's ways are everlasting. God does not change his mind. God is not intimidated by situation. God is never put in a place of confusion and disappointment. God is not hopeless or helpless. God can never be saturately immersed by your situation that God is confused about what you're going through. You get what I'm saying, sweet?
Amen.
God is not limited.
It's not.
God is not oppressed. There's no situation that is out of God's control. God's not going to wake up and go, gee, did you see man has just developed an atomic bomb? My God, what is man trying to do? Whoa, man just developed a new airplane. Oh, my God. No. God sees the end from the beginning.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
God sees your future before you were formed or created.
Mm-hmm.
And if you learn to depend on the sovereignty of God, whatever situation you find yourself, God has already made ways out for you. There are so many ways.
Mm-hmm.
His ways are everlasting. Did you get that?
Oh, yes.
His ways are everlasting.
Mm-hmm.
His ways are everlasting. Whatever you need, God has already gone ahead to prepare it for you. Okay, all right. There are many reasons for this most comforting truth. Among them are the following. The Lord's way are the result of wise deliberation. And the commentary is saying that this will be good news to you because everything about the ways of the Lord is grounded in wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
It took wisdom for God to create that ways, that path. God did not just hop one day and say, yeah. No, God thought about it thoroughly. Let us make man.
Mm.
Let there be light. And you might be worried, why is there light? Well, now you know. Science is discovering what wisdom has already concluded.
Wow.
Everything science is discovering right now,
mm-hmm.
God is like, whoa, congratulations. So you just discovered this, that plants need the light to feed. Whoa, that there's energy in light, that light can give electricity, solar energy. Whoa, congratulations. You just discovered it. Because when God says, let there be light, there was light.
Mm-hmm.
And that light is life.
That's right.
That light can give life to man.
Mm-hmm.
And you go, what? If it gives life to plant, it can sure give life to man.
Oh, yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
See, the wisdom of everything about the ways of God is deliberated in wisdom.
That's right.
So when God made you and I, we are product of God's wisdom. We're not product of chance.
Mm-hmm.
When God made the devil and the demons, God knew that you were going to have dominion over the spirit.
Mm-hmm.
So the wisdom of God in this is that you, a man that had not had the power to dominate the enemy,
mm-hmm.
all of a sudden, you are seated with Christ
Hallelujah.
In the heavenly realm. Somebody getting that now?
Oh, yes,
see, that's
God.
The wisdom of God. All of a sudden, you are elevated.
Mm-hmm.
You that talk. Oh, my God, my God. Haven't you discovered the wisdom of God for your life? What that wisdom is doing right now?
That's right.
That you that were weary, unoppressed, I mean, you couldn't achieve anything on your own.
Mm-hmm.
Now, by the wisdom of God, regardless of how many powers is out there,
mm-hmm.
it makes no difference. For one with God is more than majority in the whole world.
Mm-hmm.
See, I'm talking about the wisdom that brings a testimony in your life.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Okay, let me sidetrack here. I think I've got a nugget now. I want to run. I just need a bullet. And I've got the ammunition right now. Let me run with that wisdom right now. The wisdom of God. There is a wisdom that gives power to your
mm-hmm.
testimony.
Mm-hmm.
There is a wisdom that gives insight to your deliberations in life. There is a wisdom that is from above, that is superior.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God. His ways are everlasting. It is that wisdom that the enemy cannot limit. When that wisdom get hold of your life, there is no power, there is no dispensation, there is no authority that can keep you bound. When you have that wisdom of God, you have that in-depth wisdom of God's ability to move on your behalf. No news is bad news.
That's right.
There is no bad news to that child of God, to that man or woman of God that has the wisdom of God. Because wisdom is the principal thing.
That's right.
Wisdom solves problems.
Yes, Lord.
Wisdom is a necessity just like air and water.
Mm-hmm.
It is a necessity to life.
Mm-hmm.
When you have the wisdom of God, you are free. Your soul is liberated from fear, from demonic oppression, from frustration, from
Lord.
Confusion, from demotion. When you have the wisdom of God, you can accomplish great things in your life. You can move above and beyond all of life standard. When you have the wisdom of God, you can go forward in life. You can move ahead of life.
Mm-hmm.
You can go deeper with life. See, that's what wisdom does for you. there is a wisdom that moves you to a higher place in life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Woo!
I said, there is a wisdom. There is a wisdom. It moves you to a higher standard. There's a wisdom. It brings you out of demotion, out of frustration. There is a wisdom. When that wisdom gets old, its ways are everlasting.
My God.
It is the wisdom that pre-emitted, that pre-existed before the devil or powers of darkness were formed. It is that very vein in God. What makes God God is because he's a wise God. Mm-hmm. That's why the Bible says he's the only wise God, to the only wise God. You see, that's his title, to the only wise God. King eternal. He is the only wise God. He's the only wise God. There's no other God as intelligent than him.
Oh, yes.
There is no other God filled with wisdom like this God. You get what I'm saying?
Oh, yes.
So he is referred to as the only wise God. The God of all authority. The God of all genuity. The God of all integrity. You hear what I'm saying? The God of all sources and power and grace.
He is.
The God of all comfort. You know what I'm talking about, right? He's such an awesome king. You know, called the wisdom of God? The wisdom of God. Now, you see, the wisdom of God, his ways are everlasting. He's the God that made fire, right? So you talk fire consumes matter, right? But when the wisdom of God dwells in you, fire cannot destroy the wisdom of God in you. Like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. You see, they were asked to worship a demon.
That's right.
Listen, King Nebuchadnezzar told them. He said, let me tell you guys. I know of Daniel's God, but for you, I know you worship God like Daniel, but I don't think Daniel God is your God. So let me make it clear to you. If you refuse to bow down to this demon I've created, this idol, I'll frustrate you. Have anyone told you that they're going to frustrate you in life? Say, I will show you something. Well, if you want to show somebody something, you want to deal with someone, you must first of all be very wise than that person, smart than that person, know more than that person. Because it is impossible for an 8-year-old child to deal with you that is mature, that gave birth to that child, seeing that you are more wise, more experienced in life than that child itself. Are you getting me? It will be lunatic for one of my kids to come and say, Dad, I want to deal with you right now today. But I'll go, what am I hearing? Are you sure? First of all, we'll beat the demon out of that child. Amen. And we'll do the deliverance out of that child. Amen. And then we ask again, do you want to deal with me? You say, no, I never said that. You didn't understand what I meant. Glory to God. Hallelujah. No. That's how life is with the enemy. It is impossible for the devil to say, God, I'm going to deal with you. I want to show God that I can deal with God. It's impossible for the devil to say, you know, you're worshiping God. You are in trouble for worshiping God. I'm going to, no. That is blah, 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 blah. That's foolishness.
Oh,
yes. I always joke with that. A witch will say, oh, I'm a witch. I'm going to kill you. Well, are you mad? Have you lost your mind? Go kill other people that are foolish. Hello, there's many people to kill, not a righteous man. Glory to God, amen. It's like the devil tells you, you're not going to succeed in life. And you believe that thought. Oh, Pastor, what is wrong with you? Whose report will you believe? Because when it comes to belief, it's what you do. The devil cannot interfere in that. God himself will not stop that. That is the only thing that makes you you. Your belief system, it is your choice. God does not force it on nobody, so the devil has no right to force anything on you. It is your choice. According to your faith, be it done unto you. According to your faith, not my faith. It's got to be your faith, not my faith. Your faith, not my faith, your faith. So Nebuchadnezzar said to these kids, three young boys, say, listen, is it true that I heard that you don't bow down? He says, yes, we don't. He says, it's okay, see that furnace? It was made for people like you. I'm so smart. I knew that people would disobey.
Mm-hmm.
So I prepared this furnace for people like you. So that when you choose to disobey, you'll be taught a lesson. Well, it is impossible to teach God's children a lesson in life.
My God.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God trains his children. God does not teach them a lesson.
Mm-hmm.
God trains them. So it is illegal for the devil to teach you a lesson.
That's right.
But Nebuchadnezzar didn't lack, he lacked wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
So he said, bind them and put them in fire. Now the boys told him, they said, listen.
Mm-hmm.
Let's establish a fact now. You know, we need to understand each other in this matter.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a bad life. There is a testimony.
Mm-hmm.
We don't love our life even unto death. Well, these guys never had Revelation 12:11, but they knew the principles of God. That if you trust God wholeheartedly,
mm-hmm.
that if you pour out your life to God, you take risk for God. God has guaranteed and ensured your destiny.
Hmm.
My God.
Mm.
Did you get that?
Oh, yes.
Listen. So the guy says, oh, you're talking to me like that? Yes, I'm talking to you like that.
Mm-hmm.
Are you sure? Final answer? Oh, yes. Double final answer. Ah. All right, we shall see. Well, what is the wisdom of God there? The wisdom of God is in the word of God. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego had read the book of Isaiah.
Mm-hmm.
Where God says, when you go through the fire, I will be with you.
Mm-hmm.
Huh?
Mm-hmm.
They've also understood Isaiah 54 that says, behold, I have created the blacksmith who blows the coals in the fire,
mm-hmm.
who brings forth an instrument for his work, and I've created the spoiler to destroy. See, there's a wisdom when you know who's the creator.
That's right.
When you have a deep understanding whose you are and what you can become.
Mm.
Who is the creator and what the creator does
My God.
What the creator can do.
That's right.
And what the creator can bring about in your life.
He creates the righteous and the wicked.
My God.
He is the one that forms them.
My God.
And so he created the blacksmith who fans the coal in the fire and says, no weapon, because I created both of them. So no weapon that is forged from the enemy will do anything to you.
You see, it's the blacksmith that works coals with fire.
That's right.
So anything a fire, a man says cannot burn you.
It can't burn you.
Jesus.
My God.
Is someone hearing what I'm saying this
mm-hmm.
one?
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Oh, Pastor, the place is hot. Things are just hard. They are frustrating me. Well, frustrate them.
That's right.
What? He says, be gentle as dove. He didn't say be foolish like a dove. He only said be gentle like a dove, but be wise like a serpent.
Mm-hmm.
Who in his wisdom, in his normal mind, will go take a snake and say, I want to play with you?
Mm-hmm.
Huh? But there is a God. Listen, hear me. There is a God. The God of all wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
The God of all might and all authority. He has the ability to transform your destiny.
Hallelujah.
In his wisdom, he has prepared you for glory.
Thank you, Lord.
In his wisdom, he has... See, that's the testimony of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Christ is a wise God. He's the only wise mm-hmm. God.
Oh,
there's
yes,
a testimony
is.
In Christ Jesus.
He is.
The testimony, one of the basic testimony you have is that formerly you were lost. In the past, you were out of sync. In the past, you were foolish. Because sin is foolishness.
Mm-hmm.
Sin, can you imagine? A whole book is written. And it says, this is what's going to happen if you do this and this. This is the future of so and so. And you have the book in your hand. In fact, in this country, it's very cheap. You have it in your hand. And you say, well, I don't believe it. Well, it means you're a fool.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's just a book written by man. Well, then you're a real big fool. Well, I don't think what he says is going to happen. Oh, we will see. The Apostle Paul says, if this life, if all we have in this life, if there's no heaven or no hell, he says, we Christians are to be pitied
mm-hmm.
because we've missed in life.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego knew the word of God. They knew the wisdom of God. They knew what that wisdom can do.
Mm-hmm.
They understood the power of God's ability. So when they were thrown in the fire, they laughed.
Mm-hmm.
The king that put them on the flames, eyes was open. He says, wait. I see somebody else like the Son of God.
Mm.
You see,
my God.
Wisdom makes you see Christ.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's your eyes open.
It opens your eyes. You become enlightened.
Mm.
When you are an enlightened believer, you see things in the whole big picture. When you are an enlightened believer, you discover the possibilities of God's power and glory.
Mm.
When you are an enlightened believer, you know His ways are everlasting. That the ways of God are from one generation to another. That the ways of God are everlasting. Hey.
Hallelujah.
Hey. There is no surprise when it comes to God.
Mm.
Let me say it again.
Mm-hmm.
There is no surprise when it comes to God.
Mm-hmm.
Your whole life is not a surprise.
Mm-mm.
What you think is a mess, if you allow the wisdom of God to come into that very same situation,
mm-hmm.
you will discover that out of that mess comes glory.
Hallelujah.
Out of ashes comes beauty. It says, beauty for ashes. You know what ashes is? Beauty for ashes.
Mm-hmm.
Out of what you think the enemy has ruined comes glory.
Mm-hmm.
They were thrown into the fire to become ashes, but they came out beauty more glorified.
Mm.
They came out of that flames more honored.
Mm-hmm.
Can you imagine hundreds of thousands of people worshiping in a valley? And yet and behold, they wanted to make you a public disgrace, a public spectacle, a shame. They wanted to make you something that will become a demotion to you. And all of a sudden, that which the enemy, hallelujah,
amen.
That which the enemy had planned, that which the enemy thought he's got advantage of you. Hallelujah, somebody. I want you to pray with me before we continue. You are going to pray. Whatever the enemy has used in blindfolding you, today you strip it off because you have the wisdom of God. I want you to speak with your mouth this morning. Say it out loud. I have the wisdom of God. I have the wisdom of God. I have the wisdom of God. Eko moto mato lo baba. Toka baba baba lo pondo branda baba. Kora baba 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 baba. Ito brum to brin zoga. Aso baba 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 sunta. Mato ba kum do baba baba. Ora boba sukamba baba sukaba baba 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 robobo somdo baba baba mato baba baba no prando pora baba baba sonda bende broto brekula baba sente. My God, we give you glory.
Yes, Lord.
My God, we thank you.
Thank
we
you,
thank
Lord.
You for your wisdom.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you for your honor.
Yes, Lord.
Your ways are past finding.
Hallelujah.
Your ways are everlasting.
Yes, Father. Thank you, Lord.
Now, let me share this with you. Let me read something again before I go into more teaching.
Mm.
It says something. It says, His ways are the outgrowth of an immutable character.
Mm.
The word immutability in the Bible means it does not change.
Mm-hmm.
The only consistency in the whole world is God.
Mm-hmm.
God does not change.
Mm-mm.
God cannot change.
He can't.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yes.
God does not change. God cannot change. God will never change. It is impossible for God to change. God is constant, consistent.
Yes, Lord.
Is immutable.
Yes, Lord.
You cannot make God change. There's nothing you can do that will make God change. There's nothing in your power that you can bring about that can frustrate God. You don't have what it takes to frustrate God.
No way.
There's no problem in your life that can bring shame to God.
Mm-mm.
Let me drop this. This is going to bless somebody before I continue. I had a very close relative of mine. Very close. And she's been married for almost 10 years. And she didn't have a child. She prays a lot, believes God's word, but she didn't have a child. And she was there. I mean, out of everybody, we would just say, boy, I would say, this baby girl of ours, baby friend of mine, my very dear friend. I said, why is she not having a child? My God. And she's been there like that. She believed God. So I called home. And they told me, they said, hey, do you know, everything is happening. Every good news is happening. Everything good is just happening. This one got married. This is getting married. And I said, what happened? He said, oh, this one has a baby. She just had a baby day before yesterday. And I go, what am I hearing? She had a baby. She just left America. Was it August or so? Mm-hmm. I said, I know she was sick. She said she was very sick. She had the cold. And she had a baby. She didn't know she was pregnant and she had the baby. I said, all right. I called her. I said, hey, girl, what's up? Congratulations, you have a baby. My God, you have a baby. You're a real mother now. He said, yeah. He said, do you know what, Apostle? I said, what? He said, I've never seen this before, that I was pregnant. I was still having my menstrual period. I said, what? He said, all through the pregnancy, I was having period. I said, what? She said, she never knew she was pregnant. Months and months and months, she was getting big and big and big. Then my other sister told her, he says, hey girl, you need to go check the doctor. This is not just fat. Maybe you are pregnant. She says, how can I be pregnant when I say I have periods? She went to the doctor. They did all the tests. And the doctor says, yes, you are pregnant. She said, what? How come I'm having my period? He said, yes, it happens once, one in a hundred or one in a thousand, one in a million. He said, but you are pregnant. She said, she told me, said, Apostle, I was shocked to find out I'm pregnant. And yeah, I have a baby girl. I go, what? This God. Mm-hmm. And I said, what's the guest name? Oh, I love that. She said, the guest name is Osahontue, which is my name. I said, oh, is it your namesake? I said, oh, praise God. Wonderful. Wonderful. And I said, now you're making me happy. Now I like what I hear most. What am I saying to you? There is a God. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The testimonies of God can change. Mm. Hey, Pastor, I've been believing God. I told you, except you be older than Sarah, then we will add your name in the Bible. You know, let me tell you. Wait. If you get to the age of 90 and you don't have a baby yet, then we will add your name to the Bible. And we'll say, oh, this one, God could not do it. But you wait. You will never be Sarah. There's only one Sarah in the Bible. Yes. Pastor, you don't know my case. I don't care what your case is. Oh, Pastor, you're just saying that, you know, but praise God, maybe God is... His ways are immutable. God does not favor one person and says, I will not favor you. That is not God. God does not answer one person's prayer and you that call on his name and says, no, for you, I want to punish you. That is not the image of God. That is not the personality of God. The Bible says he gives rain to the wicked. Mm-hmm. And the good. Can you imagine that? Rain, mm-hmm, that is from God. Even the wicked man enjoys it. How much more you that call on God night and day? You are going to pray one more time before we continue. You are going to thank God for the immutability of his word. Mm-hmm. That God, you are the only wise God.
Yes, Lord.
You are going to find God for his wisdom. Mm-hmm. For that wisdom that makes God unique. Mm-hmm. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There is a wisdom that separates God from everything he created.
Oh, yes.
It takes wisdom to create the universe. Mm-hmm. It takes wisdom to make all the planet and all the stars.
Beautiful.
But if you have to think about the creation of God, mm-hmm, you can't sleep. Have you looked at the sea, ocean, the ocean depth? Mm-hmm. Have you looked at some creatures there? Mm-hmm. Boy, my God. Mm-hmm. Have you looked at the plant kingdom?
Mm-hmm.
The wisdom of God. His ways are everlasting. God's power has irresistible might. There is no authority that can turn the hand of God. The wisdom of God is the power of Christ in
Hallelujah.
You. It is the testimony of Christ in you.
Yes, Lord.
It is the reality of Christ in you. That Christ in you is the hope of glory. Christ in you is the hope of glory. Christ in you is the hope of glory. There is a hope. There is a hope born out of wisdom. You see, you cannot reverse the counsel of God.
No? Oh, you can't.
You cannot reverse the power of God. Church, I'm telling you this morning, I'm telling you today, that God has you insured.
Hallelujah.
God has you insured. Or God have you insured. God have you insured. He has everything you need. And he wants to give it to you free of charge. Everything you can dream of, God wants to give it to you. There is a wisdom that keeps your testimony. Oh, Jesus was crucified, right? But before he died, he had the wisdom of God. He knew in the book of Psalms, he says, you will not allow your Holy One to see decay. He was confident in that word of God. You see, when Jesus was on earth, coming down on the earth, he has to be 100% man. He had to be endowed with the Holy Spirit so he can prove that you can have the power of God in you. So he has to be 100% man. In everything he did, he has to be 100%. He had to be 100% on the bed. He had to be 100% so that you too can experience all that God has for you. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yes.
So he had to depend on the word of God. I keep on telling you, that is the wisdom of God for your lifetime. The word of God. Get into the word of God. Get into the scriptures. Understand the dynamics of the scripture. That is the promise of God. Listen, I'm telling you, that is the wisdom of God for you. That is the power of God for you. That's what God wants you to accomplish. That's what God wants you to have. That wisdom. It can change your life.
Oh, yes.
It will change your world. It will transform your destiny. The word of God is the wisdom of God. The word of God is the wisdom of God. The word of God is the wisdom of God.
Yes, Lord.
The word of God is the wisdom of God.
Hallelujah.
The word of God for you, if you can grab that Bible, study it, believe it, meditate on it. You will discover secret wisdom that governs the universe. You will discover the secret of creation. You will discover the power to transform situation. You will discover the hidden ability to move you forward. There is power in the word of God. There is authority in the word of God. There is dominion in the word of God.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, his ways are everlasting. What ways? The ways of his word. When you get a hold of that word, and the word of God begins to form in you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The word of God begins to move inside of you. The word of God begins to create situations in you. You know what's happening to you? You become, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You become a tool of power. You become a tool of dominion.
Yes, Lord.
You become a tool of authority. You know what I'm saying, sweetheart?
Oh, yes, Lord.
You become that instrument Glory to God.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You become that vessel. That glorious vessel.
That's right.
That God utilizes. You become that glorious substance that God uses. Because you're a vessel of wisdom, a vessel of honor. The ways of God are everlasting. God has you covered. You are covered by God. God's ways are the manifestation of the eternal principles of right. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, God's ways are the of eternal of right. There's no wrong in it. So it's always righteous. Righteousness. It goes in the right direction. I want to listen, church. I want you to understand something about your life. Your world. Your circumstance. I had something yesterday while one of the ministers was ministering. And for real, I've not seen that part before. And as she was ministering, she said something that was so amazing by the Holy Ghost. She's a wonderful teacher. She was just ministering. I enjoyed her teaching yesterday. And she was saying something. And she said, if you compare 1 Samuel 22 and 2 Samuel 22, I've never heard that before. You find a significant. You see, the Bible is coded. I keep on telling you, when you say chapter 1, verse 1, is if you understand the mystery of the coding of the Bible, you solve your life's problem. In 1 Samuel 22, David ran away to the cave. He just left Achish, the Philistine king, and played the fool. He played like he was a madman. Because he was almost killed. He had to escape. They brought him to Achish. And what Achish wanted to do with him was to bring him to his house. It means to make him a prisoner. So David played the fool. And David escaped and went into the cave of Adullam. The Bible says, let me know, that everyone that was in debt, problem, chaos, they left Israel and went to meet him. Hopeless, ragged people with no direction. Yet, if you fast forward to 2 Samuel 22, David now begins to give God thanks and honor for the wisdom of God in bringing such people because they became David's mighty men.
My God.
Definitely, it is wisdom that takes a people in debt, a people bound in servitude, confusion and disappointment. It takes wisdom to transform them to become mighty men of valor, to become men of riches and wealth and substance. And now you see this David that once lived in cave, now in a palace, praising God and say, boy, I'm about to build something for you.
My God.
It is the wisdom of God that takes you from the place of poverty, lack and chaos into the palace of life. And that is your testimony.
Yes, Lord.
But the Bible says Jesus became poor so that you can be rich. He became weak so that you can be strong. So what's the wisdom? Because that is the only means of exchange. If he was born into Herod's palace, then the poor folks like you and I who were once poor will never have access to him. It will become a royalty. It means every king and queen on the earth will have the anointing of Jesus. See, the wisdom of God is always above man. So he was born the least place any man could have been given birth to. Glory to God.
Glory.
So that it's not by birth order. It's not by birth right. It's your faith. It is your disposition. It is up to you to embrace the wisdom of God. His ways are everlasting. You cannot think for God. Why couldn't you sleep? Well, I was just thinking for God, you know. I was just thinking if God would be nice to do this for me. Oh, boy, boy, stop it now. Stop it, stop it, stop it. You can't think for God. His ways are past finding out. There is a testimony in the wisdom of God. There is a testimony. I'm talking about the testimony of Christ. Mm-hmm. Christ was endowed with the wisdom of God. Mm-hmm. Christ operated under the anointing of that wisdom. Mm-hmm. Isaiah 11, quickly. Look at Isaiah chapter 11. Isaiah chapter 11. Oh my God. Isn't God wonderful?
Yes,
isn't God wonderful? I got another testimony I'm going to share with you. Isn't God wonderful? Isn't God wonderful? Isn't God wonderful?
Yes,
he is. Yeah, 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 yeah. Go to Isaiah chapter 11. You see, say it out. I will never be broke again.
I will never be broke again.
Say it again to your mouth. Say, I will never be poor again.
Never be poor again.
I'll never be miserable again.
I'll never be miserable again.
I'll never be sick again.
I'll never be sick again.
Now, when I say that, you go, oh, Pastor, we are all in this world that we get sick. Abba. Well, flu is not sickness. When I mean sick, I mean that which kills your body.
Mm-hmm.
That which destroys your body. That which circumvents God's purpose for your life.
Mm-hmm.
You see, now I've said that word, you are struggling to believe it. Your mind is bummed. Oh, Pastor, I don't think everybody gets sick. No, you see, that's what I'm saying now. You're becoming like everybody. Psalm 103 says, He has healed all our diseases.
Mm-hmm.
He has taken, you can stand on that word of God. God, you've taken away our diseases.
Mm-hmm.
Who takes away all our diseases? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Woo!
Mm-hmm.
My God, did you get that?
Oh, yeah.
You get excited with the word of God because that's the wisdom of God. So what happens now that you are sick? Speak the word.
That's right. Speak the word.
His ways are everlasting.
Mm-hmm.
There's no change. There's no expiration date.
Mm-hmm.
Have you discovered this fact, people of God? That every medication created has an expiration date.
Mm-hmm.
I was shocked when I discovered that every drug made has an expiration date. So I begin to say, it's not medicine you want to heal person. No, because they have to make money. Now, this is where the manipulation comes in. So if you want it to heal, how come you put an expiration date on it? Now you figure it out. Now you're wise. But the word of God has no expiration date.
Hallelujah.
The promise of healing, the promise of health.
There's no
expiration date to the wisdom of God.
Oh,
you see, it's so different from the wisdom of man. Huh?
Mm-hmm.
Man wants you to get well and get sick again so he makes money off you.
Mm-hmm.
But God wants you to stay well and stay well so that you become like him.
Hallelujah.
Woo! Oh, you like that, right? Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
My God. You see that?
Glory.
Even the cars that men make, it has engine problem. After a while, they'll tell you comfort. Have you driven those cars that when you keep on driving, something show up on your dashboard? Pam. You know, I'll try to figure out how they know when I have to do my oil change. When the guy changes the oil, the guy puts a sticker, you know,
mm-hmm.
and says, after so mild, you must come to change your oil. And he puts his phone number there so you know where to come next time. Amen?
Amen.
And then you keep on driving. But the minute it gets to that, exactly what that guy said, the red light, the yellow light, or whatever color shows up on your screen. You go, what? And you look at the date. It's exactly, I want to think the mechanics are prophets of their rights. Amen? I mean, the prophets will take your money because they know how to time you. But God's word does not exploit you. As long as you get into that word of God. As long as you embrace the prophetic voice of God,
mm-hmm.
as long as you embrace the promises of God, guess what? You need no servicing.
Mm. Hallelujah.
Because the word of God keeps you going on.
Mm-hmm.
The word of God creates your environment. It is the wisdom that transforms you.
Mm-hmm.
It secures the testimony of Christ in you. Isaiah 11. Isaiah chapter 11 verse 1. And there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse. Mm-hmm. It's talking about this same David. Mm-hmm. A rod out of the stem of Jesse. Jesse. Mm-hmm. Since we can't get by this man, David's father. Obed, son. Ruth, grandson. Mm-hmm. Ruth was alive to see him. Ruth saw him grow up. Mm. Hallelujah.
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 Root. From root again. Mm-hmm. Root. Obed. Obed. Jesse. Obed got some wealth from Boaz as inheritance. Mm. So Obed was born into wealth and resources. Mm. But Root came from the lowest level of life mm-hmm. into that place of wealth. Mm-hmm. The wisdom of God.
That's right.
And then Root's grandson. Naomi's great-grandson, Jesse. Out of the stem of Jesse, there comes a rod. And a branch shall grow out of his roots. A branch. Something unique. Mm-hmm. Something new. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon this branch. Mm-hmm. Well, he says, he is the branch, you are the vine. So, mm-hmm. Jesus, there's a power in the branch. You see, it is the branch that brings life to the tree.
That's right.
A tree without branch cannot do well. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah, somebody.
Hallelujah.
The branch is connected to the root.
That's right.
The branch gives vitamins to the root. And out of the branch comes the vine. Hmm. It says, I'm the vine. You are the branches. Mm-hmm. I'm that stem. Mm-hmm. That stem is that vine. Mm-hmm. Ay, 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 ay. And you are the branches. You are part of me. I am part of you. I walk through you. I want to do glorious things through you. Mm-hmm. I want to empower your life. Get above that situation you think is tying mm-hmm. you down. You are above that situation. Mm-hmm. You are above that circumstances. Oh, the world is getting bad, but for you, it's getting brighter.
That's right.
I am so excited for the future because every day it brings me to glory.
That's right.
It draws me closer to my glorious manifestation. Mm.
Hallelujah.
Pastor, pray that the year will not go because I heard next year is going to be very, very bad. Oh, yes, I will tell you it's going to be worse than this year, but it's going to be the best year ever for me and you. Mm-hmm. How? Because the word of God says so. Mm-hmm. Darkness shall cover the earth. Gross darkness shall cover the people. But the Lord shall arise on me. Mm. Woo, hallelujah.
And his glory,
and his glory shall be seen on us.
That's right.
It is written. It's a law. Mm. It is a word. Mm-hmm. You can't change. You don't wake up and change the word of God. Mm-mm. It's permanent. It's eternal. You can't change the word of God. You cannot change the word of God. Yes. I dare you to change the word of God. You have no right to change the word of God. Mm. You like that, don't you?
Oh, yes.
My God, my God. It is sweet. But look at this. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon me. Mm-hmm. I don't know about you. One thing I'm sure about is myself.
That's right.
And Pastor Felicia here with me right now. Because you can say amen, but your heart is not there. Amen. Hallelujah. That I've seen folks, you finish prayer, they say, Pastor, pray for me again. Say, but I just prayed for you before you say, no, that one was everybody. Pray another one again. Oh, Lord, help me. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon me, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding. Did you hear that? The Spirit of wisdom. The Spirit of wisdom. It is the testimony of Christ that you are wise.
That's right.
Mm. And the Spirit of counsel. And might. The first thing is that the gate is the Spirit of wisdom. When that Spirit of Christ come on you, the only wise God. My God. Your circumstance is not a challenge to you. You don't have a problem. And then when I say that, you go, oh, not again. But pastor. But no. But sister. But brother. You don't have a problem. All you need is the wisdom of God.
Oh, yes.
And it's been given to you for free. I didn't ask you to pay any check to get it. I can't even sell it. It's unsellable. It's not resellable, I mean. Amen?
Amen.
It's free.
It's free.
Totally free. Absolutely free. You don't have to stand in the queue to see a man to get it. Why waste your time on that? No man can give you the wisdom of God. The gifts of God cannot be given by a man. It is the Holy Spirit. And that Spirit is free. You can have it right now. That wisdom that will hold your testimony, because the ways of God are past finding. The ways of God are past finding. Oh my God, they brought seed. Pray with me in the Holy Ghost this morning. Pray with me in the Holy Ghost. I want you to pray in the Holy Ghost. Pray in the Holy Spirit, the wisdom of God.
Yes, Lord.
Enter into that new wisdom. The ways of God are everlasting. Your ways are everlasting. They are past finding. There's a wisdom behind my creation. Every ways of God, the ways of God is established in wisdom. It has been tested. It has been proven to be true. It has been proven to be righteous. It has been proven to work. The wisdom of it always works. It always works. It has been proven to work.
See,
it has been proven to work. God is not trying to make it work for you. It has been proven to work.
Thank you,
the wisdom
Father.
Of God works all
Hallelujah.
The time.
Blessed be your name,
the wisdom
God.
Of God works all the time.
Yes, Lord.
It has been proven to work. It has a testimony that it works.
Yes,
it
Lord.
Always works. It will always work.
That's
it
right.
can never fail to work.
That's right.
It can never cease from
my God. Woo!
You get that
glory,
right?
Glory, glory.
It's a proven fact.
Yes, Lord.
And God wants you to understand that. There is a wisdom out there for you. There's a wisdom that will benefit your life.
Mm-hmm.
There's a wisdom that will profit your life.
That's
There's
right.
a wisdom that will equip your life. There's a wisdom that will...
Oh, yes.
You get that, right?
Hallelujah.
It's right there for you.
Mm-hmm.
It's right there. It is yours.
Hallelujah.
I receive fresh wisdom.
Praise
the
you,
Spirit
Lord.
Of the Lord rest on me this morning. The Spirit of wisdom
yes,
from
Holy
God.
Spirit
begin
God.
To prophesy.
Marcos,
I speak the wisdom of God. I speak the
him.
Wisdom of God.
It,
so
this morning,
it changes my life.
The Spirit of God will welcome you. Will receive you. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Somebody talk to God. Begin to talk to God this morning. I want you to talk to God this morning. I want you to talk to God this morning.
Receive the wisdom of God. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Marcos, the wisdom of God, the power of God.
Yes, Lord.
I come to the place of wisdom.
Yes, Lord.
I operate in divine wisdom.
In the name
I have
of Jesus
access to divine
Christ.
Wisdom.
Oh, God.
The wisdom that changes my world.
My God.
It changes my life.
Yes,
I operate
Lord.
In that wisdom.
Yes, Lord.
I'm above and not beneath.
Yes, Lord.